हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन द सीरीज ऑफ एजुकेशनल वीडियो दैट वी आर मेकिंग टुडे आई एम हेयर विथ वन मोर वीडियो ऑन हाउ टू टेक विनिंग डिसीजंस। सो आर यू ऑल्सो फसी अबाउट चेंजिंग डिसीजंस? डू यू ऑल्सो गेट कन्फ्यूज वाइल मेकिंग डिसीजंस? दिस इज एक्चुअली अ ऑब्वियस थिंग दैट एवरी ह्यूमन बींग फेसेज। सो ह्यूमन बींग एक्चुअली इज अ इमोशनल क्रिएचर। वी टेंड टू फील बैड वेन एवर थिंग्स डू नॉट टर्न अराउंड एज वी वॉन्ट। वेन एवर वी हैव टू चेंज आर डिसीजंस वी डोंट फील गुड। So what should we do? Should we stick to our decisions? Sticking to our decision is not bad. But should we also switch decisions? So we'll explore this by the way of a game. We'll play a game together. And the game is called the Monte Hall problem, the Monte Hall game. It is a game of a car and a goat. We'll try to link this game with real life problem, how to tackle real life problems and all. So let's play the game together and then understand how to the ask problem solving approach and all. So I'll first of all tell you the rules of the game. I am the host of the game. It's also called a car and a goat game. There is a car, your dream gift, behind one of the doors, and there are some other booby gifts behind other two doors. Say the rules of the game is that I'll ask you to choose a door and I'll not open that door. I can open any two other doors. So what I'll do is I'll open one of the other doors and then I'll throw back the decision on you, whether you want to stick to your decision or you want to change your decision. Based on what decision you make, I'll open that door. I'll not shift the position of the car and the goat and all. So if I open a door that has a car, so I'll give you the car and all. So obviously I'll not open the door that has a car. So let's play it together. Actually, you can play this game with your friends, this being recording. I'll presume my answer to be yours and all. So, but you can play it with your friends and find it out. Let's begin the game. So there are door 1, 2 and 3 and I'll ask you to choose one of the door. And you chose door 1. Now, I'll not open the door 1 as per the rule of the game. I can open door 2 and door 3. So what I did, I'd open door 3 and I revealed you a goat. Now I threw back the decision again on you and asked you whether you want to stick to your original decision of door 1 or you want to switch your decision. So I think you are a bit confused and I'll help you out on this, and then it's your opinion. Decision is always yours. Then let's try to work it out together. What is actually happening is that there are three doors and the probability, a chance of the car being behind any one of the door is 1/3, because there are three doors and every door has equal chance. So door A has also 1/3, door B 1/3, door C 1/3. So you chose door A and you are having 1/3 chance that you can win a car. Now what I did is when I opened and door B and C cumulative chances 1/3 + 1/3 = 2/3. So this is what is the scenario. Now when I opened door 3, I revealed you a goat, and then the chance of 1/3 chance of the car being behind door 3 is now gone. It is zero. So what actually happens is the chance of the goat, the car being behind door 2 shifts, changes to 2/3. It's actually upgrades. It increases. So now I gave you this rationale that because of the chance of the car, since the goat is in one of the behind one of the door 3, so possibility of the and the cumulative possibility of 2 and 3 was 2/3. So since 3 is now 0, the entire 2/3 possibility of the car being behind door 2 is 2/3. So I suggested you and you also accepted my suggestion and you won. Now what came to your mind is what would have happened, because I am not shifting the position of the car, what would have happened if I would have chosen gate number 2. So I'll help you out on this also. Let's work it out. Now you chose door B, and now in the same way, now the door A and door C is 1/3, 1/3, cumulative being 2/3. So since I revealed a goat behind डोर थ्री द पॉसिबिलिटी आई सेड ऑफ द कार बींग बिहाइंड डोर वन इज 2/3 एंड नाउ आई आस्क यू टू शिफ्ट टू योर डिसीजन टू डोर वन एंड यू एक्सेप्टेड माई डिसीजन दिस टाइम ऑल्सो एंड बट यू लॉस्ट सॉरी सो नाउ यू लॉस्ट एंड यू आर वरीड दैट आई स्विच माई डिसीजन आई लॉस्ट सो इट इज नॉट दैट यू आर यू हैव लॉस्ट इट इज बाई चांस दैट यू हैव लॉस्ट एक्चुअली देर इज समथिंग कॉल लक सो इट्स योर बैड लक दैट यू हैव लॉस्ट बट यू शुड नॉट बी वरीड दैट आई टुक अ रॉन्ग डिसीजन बिकॉज रैशनली यू टुक अ राइट डिसीजन वॉट इज हैपनिंग इज दे आई हैव गिवन यू सम एडिशनल इन्फॉर्मेशन एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट दैट एडिशनल इन्फॉर्मेशन द पॉसिबिलिटी and the results are changing. So you have taken account of that additional information and you took the decision based on that additional information that I gave it to you. If you would have not taken that additional information into account, then see the possibility was always 1/3, but due to some additional information, it can be very well explained in the way that say there was a car behind door 2 and door 3, then since you have chosen a door and to door 1. So I could not open door 2 because the car is behind door 2. I will be forced to open door 3 only. So there is a possibility that if the car goat is behind both the doors 2 and 3, then I can open any door 2 being door 3. But if there is a car behind any of the two doors that you have not chosen, then I am bound to open only the door that is not having the car. I cannot reveal the car to you. Otherwise, you will take the car. So that is what is happening. This that additional information is forcing me also to take a specific decision. And you are taking cognizance of that additional information, that my behavior also. This is what is called the game theory. And you can very well, it's a very good field of study, game theory. You should study. I'll recommend you studying this game theory. So this is what I wanted to share with you. In the real life also, what kids today are facing is that they take a decision. They take a decision that they'll go into some stream, they'll do something, and they because of the time and energy and all whatever they have devoted and all, when things don't turn around in the way they want, they feel bad and they try to stick to their decisions without taking cognizance of the additional information, if any. Sticking to decision, I am not saying it's bad, but what I am saying is you should always take account of the additional information that are coming to you. You should not ignore the additional information. In the financial market also, whenever you buy shares and all, we try to feel that we buy shares feeling that it will go up. So it's not that only, it may be true that it may go up also, but if some additional information are coming, we should take account of that. And we can switch. We should sell it off if things are not good, going in the direction we want and all. We should not stick to our decision and ignore the additional information. That is what was the purpose of this lecture, this presentation. So then what I would like to convey to you a few other things also, that is things may also, you may also feel, is decision making life so easy as I have explained to you? So what I'll submit is that it is easy. Things change a bit, but based on the problems that we encounter, we should try to rationalize in the way the problem we face the problem. So whatever you things may come into your mind, that obvious questions may come in your mind, that what would have happened if there was one goat behind one door and maybe goat behind no doors or something of that sort, that there may be three different gifts in three different behind three different doors and all. What would we do in those case and all? So we can approach that problem, and how we should approach those issues, we'll explain it. We'll try to explore together also in the subsequent videos. But the only point I would like to make here is that we should think of a problem, and we should evaluate the problem on the basis of two things, one being the utility and the other being the risk. What is the utility associated? Risk and reward. So based on those aspects, and decisions are taken on the basis of the possibility of an outcome. Here we had an equal possibility of all three outcomes, one third, one third, one third. There may be instances when wherein the possibility of one outcome is more, other outcome is less. So we should take cognizance of those things, and then based on those things we should take decision. You can read Bayesian updating. This is a problem of conditional probability that I have discussed today, but I made it a real life example. It's a proven fact, proven theorem. So whenever we do get additional information, whenever we change our decision based on the additional information, that is actually called Bayesian updating. We'll try to, whatever I'm saying, that we'll try together to take decisions into different, taking different aspects of utility and risk and all. So that those things are also there. So we'll discuss it. For the time being, I would like you to share your observations on decision making. What are your experiences? And together we'll explore. Till then, I'll like to take your leaves. Thank you. Thank you for listening.